Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Allison and I am doing a video series on hospitality and Christian hospitality. This is actually the second video in the series. Today I want to talk about hospitality and how to do it. And one of the things that holds women back from hosting people in their home is that they're self-conscious about their cooking or about their home. So I shared in one of my earlier videos about why we moved, and one of those reasons that we moved was to be closer to fellowship with those who are part of our church. We really wanted to grow in relationships with those in our church family, and one of the ways that we are now able to do that is that we have moved closer to the community, and we are now in the community where our church is. And because of that, we have been able to consistently invite people over from our church so that we can fellowship with them and get to know them and have them in our home. So one of the reasons that was shared with me about why Christian women are inviting people into their homes is that they're self-conscious about either their home or their cooking. In my previous video, I talked about the heart behind hospitality. So I'm gonna go ahead and link that above so that you can watch that if you haven't yet. So starting with that, the heart behind hospitality is going to be your motivation behind everything that you're doing. I want to read here a little passage from Romans chapter 12. It's verses 9 through 13. Let love be without hypocrisy. Abhor what is evil, cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Give preference to one another in honor, not lagging behind in diligence, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord, rejoicing in hope, persevering in tribulation, devoted to prayer, contributing to the needs of the saints, practicing hospitality. So the reason that I picked that really is because I think it really speaks so much to why, the why behind hospitality. We are to love others without selfish ambition, outdo one another with giving preference, and we can open our homes and do as Paul says in Romans 12. We can welcome others into our homes so that together we can rejoice together in our mutual hope in Christ's finished work on the cross. We can be there for one another to edify and persevere with one another in the faith and persevere with one another through tribulation. We can be devoted with one another in prayer and praying for each other. In Romans 12:13, it says, we are to contribute to the needs of the saints, practicing hospitality. The word contribute comes from a Greek word that means commonality, partnership, or mutual sharing, which is often translated fellowship or communion. As believers in the body of Christ, we need communion with one another. And there is a list of basic things that we need one another in the body for. It's really outlined here in Romans 12. Back to what I said in my previous video, there really is a heart motivation behind why we're inviting others into our home. We have to remember what the Bible says about the body of Christ and how we're to associate with one another. We need one another. We need those relationships with one another so that we can encourage and edify and spur one another on in good works. We need one another too to come alongside each other, to carry our burdens and to carry another's burdens, to help brothers and sisters go on in times of tribulation. We also need one another to pray with each other and to also worship God together. God gives us the body in order that we can help and meet one another's needs. So all of these eternal purposes for fellowship infinitely outweigh the appearance or level of wealth displayed in your home and your cooking. All of these things have eternal value that come from fellowship and communion with other believers in your home and hospitality. None of those things measure up to if you're just not a good cook. It doesn't matter if you're ordering hot and readies when you're worshiping God. Okay, so now that the eternal value of practicing hospitality has been established, let's just talk about the practical aspects of it. If you feel self-conscious about inviting people into your home, I think the first thing I would say is evaluate your heart. What is your heart motivation behind it, and why do you feel self-conscious? I met a missionary that is in India that came here and spoke at our church a couple weeks ago, and he describes the way that they fellowship in India with other believers is sitting on a concrete floor. And he's so grateful to have just a couple other believers to sit there and fellowship with. We take for granted so much what we have here and how blessed we are. And when we begin to lose focus on the eternal value of communing with the saints and practicing hospitality, inviting others into our home, we lose sight of what a gracious gift God has given us here. By focusing on not having the comfiest couches or the newest couches or the nicest china to serve food onto your guests, by making those your focus, you can really miss the point of hospitality altogether. So here's what you can do. Clean and tidy your home before your guests arrive. If you don't have adequate seating, ask them to bring chairs or borrow some. The purpose is not to impress, so we gotta check our pride on stuff like this. If you don't have enough to host, there's nothing wrong with asking people to bring seating or asking people to bring a dish so that you can get together and fellowship. The point of fellowship is not to show off. It's not to spend extravagantly to impress other people. Once that becomes the focus is now on you and not on worshiping God together. If we're gathering together in our homes to glorify God, what kind of plate we're eating our food on doesn't matter at all. Whether you have folding chairs or if you have enough lounge furniture to seat all of your guests, it doesn't make a difference in the level of glorifying to God this hospitality is. So let's talk about food. Simplify, simplify, simplify. Think about the easiest meals for a crowd. The point of fellowship is not to impress other people with your culinary skills. If this is one of your gifts, by all means, cook that chicken to the glory of God. Do what you do best if you are a good cook. And if not, don't worry about that. Focus on your other gifts. If your gift is exhortation or if your gift is encouragement, use your gifts to better the body through hospitality. Use your gifts when they come into your home. If your gift is music, bless your guests with your music. I think another thing too is really focusing on not spending all of your time while your guests are in your home by standing at the stove. Try to create a meal where it is ready when your guests arrive and that you can sit there and enjoy fellowshipping with them and that it's not something that requires work in order to continue on. So think like a crock pot meal. Think soups and bread that are already done and complete before people arrive. Simply feeding people and joining together over food, it doesn't have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be extravagant. It can be very simple and people enjoy simple because most people have simple lives. Don't forget that potlucks are also acceptable. The point is the fellowship, it's not the food and that you yourself have created the food. So really, I hope that this series encourages you to open up your home and to practice fellowship with more intentionality, to really focus on the heart behind hospitality, focus on the fellowship with other believers and opening your home to meet the practical needs of other believers. Really focus on carrying one another's burdens and getting to know somebody else so that you can walk alongside them and encourage them in their faith and in their life and in their marriage and in their home. The point of fellowship should really be the relationship that you're building with someone else and not about what's being displayed in your home or your setup in your home. All of those things really don't matter, and all of those things fade into the background when you're communing together with the body of Christ and you are worshiping God together and you're opening your Bible with other believers and you're discussing the scriptures and you're really growing in your faith and spurring others on to grow in their faith. To commune with other believers and open your home and practice hospitality in that way to allow for that to happen, the focus is to glorify God. The focus is not to glorify us in our home and our homemaking skills and our cooking skills. None of that should be the focus at all. So I hope this video encourages you. I hope that it encourages you to not worry about whatever level of culinary skills you have or don't have, and that it's okay to have ladies over for some coffee and some store-bought cookies. As long as you're sitting there talking about Jesus together and loving the Lord, you are glorifying God in your fellowship, okay? Thanks for watching. I hope you will leave your best tips for cooking and for hosting down below. Please keep it encouraging. Please let this community be a place that can grow and encourage other women to open their homes and not feel so self-conscious about doing so. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.